Well, you guys voted, and out of the two new Jeremy fragrance releases I have, you guys chose Black Tie. Is this fragrance any good? Stay tuned to find out. Today's going to be another unboxing first impressions and update video. This time coming from the house of Fragrance One, we have Black Tie. So Black Tie from the house of Fragrance One is a men's woody spicy fragrance released in 2020. The nose behind this fragrance is Alberto Marias and is an extra de parfum concentration. Alright guys, let's check out the presentation. So here's the bottle for Black Tie. Unfortunately, I didn't get a box with this 10ml travel size. I'm not really sure if it even comes with a box, but this one didn't come with it. But I did want to do a full review for you guys, so that's why I just went ahead and included it on a full review video. But this is the bottle, a nice clear black bottle here with a plastic cap, silver atomizer. The bottles do resemble the color scheme of the newer style bottles. This is a 10ml travel and it sells for $60. All right, so here are the notes for Black Tie. In the top, we have mandarin, lemon, and orange oil. In the mid, we have guaiac wood. And in the base, we round things off with vetiver, patchouli, and cardamom. Yeah, so I do have a little bit of experience with the House of Fragrance One, Jeremy Fragrance's fragrance line. I did a video on Date for Men, and I did a video on Office for Men. I will leave links to those down below in the description if you guys want to see those. But yeah, I got a couple of fragrances from the newer releases in a swap. Got a pretty good deal on these. I do have unisex as well. I will do this video later on, but like I said before, you guys did vote and y'all chose to do, you wanted me to do Black Tie first, so I will oblige. But yeah, I was looking forward to trying this one a little bit more anyway, just judging, going off the notes. The unisex seems to be a bit more of a simpler composition. This one has a little bit more going on with it. But yeah, so it is called Black Tie, so I'm assuming it's for, you know, black tie affairs, evening out. They already have a date night, so, you know, black tie, I'm guessing just suit and tie, maybe more of a formal thing, I guess. But yeah, looking forward to this fragrance. Unfortunately, I can kind of get small wafts from the cap here. I don't see any leaks. This thing is full all the way to the top, but I'm getting a bit of a preview here, and I'm trying not to, so I'm just hoping it's going to be a lot more different on my skin than what I'm getting from the cap here. I'm really trying not to really get too much of a preview of this fragrance. So let's hope and give this fragrance our first impression. All right, here we go. Clean hand, couple sprays. Good sprayer. Okay. Yeah, definitely getting all the citrus notes. The citrus notes in this sort of remind me a little bit of the Office for Men. And I want to say that I read somewhere that Black Tie will actually go really well with Office for Men. I'm not sure how you're supposed to blend those, but it's almost like I get a little bit of that DNA in this immediately off the top. Yeah, this is a good fragrance. It's super citrusy, like almost like the orange, is it orange oil? I'm definitely getting a lot of that because it's almost like a sweet, like a orange lollipop or something. It's not like sweet, but like sugary sweet, but there's the orange oil is really lending it to that sweetness. Just very, very heavy in the orange oil, and the mandarin and the lemon obviously are going to be helping along, kind of push the citrus notes along even more. There is a bit of something in this. I'm not sure if it's the guaiac wood, but something in this is giving it slightly like a permanent marker type of smell, which I'm not really a big fan of right now. There's just something, I mean, up close, smells good. Pull the hand back a little bit. It's also what I was sort of getting a little bit from the cap earlier when I said I could kind of smell it. I was sort of getting a little bit of a permanent marker type of smell. And again, I don't know where that comes from. I'm not sure if I like that too much. Like I said, up close, it smells fantastic. Very citrusy. It's got a little bit of, there's no ambroxan in this, but it's got a little bit of that touch of that loudness that Office for Men has. I mean, honestly, you could probably pair this one with Date as well, although I think they're kind of similar. And again, I could be wrong. He might have said this one pairs better with Date than not Office, but I could have swore it was Office. If not, I stand corrected, but honestly, I think you could probably wear this or mix it with both. But again, I'm not sure. Yeah, I mean, this fragrance is nice, but I don't. It's nothing special right now. I can definitely tell there's quality there. But I'm really just getting a lot of the citrus notes, the orange oil, like I mentioned, the guaiac wood. You know, the vetiver and patchouli aren't really coming out too much right now. The cardamom maybe is giving a little bit of sexiness. A little bit of that nuttiness, but honestly, this one really isn't anything special. Especially not for the prices that I'm seeing right in front of me. I got these from the website. Again, he does do a lot of buy one, get ones, or like half offs, or just whatever kind of sale. Maybe that's the buy one, get one, but he does a lot of sales. So the price looks like a lot, but if you like do the math and end up buying two bottles, you do get one for, or like two bottles for pretty low price. You sell one, you just gotta kind of go through a little bit of work to actually make your money back. But I don't see anything really special with this fragrance. This one really isn't wowing me. I think Date for Men was probably my favorite release of his. This one, pretty complex, very loud, very ultramol on steroids with more masculine notes in this. This is almost like, I don't know, it's just like, it's kind of a darker citrusy fragrance. Citrusy, woody, and a little dark, but nothing really standing out, honestly, with this fragrance. It's not unpleasant. It's just very expensive. Like I said, 10 mil is $60 for pretty much a decant here. And 100 mil, maybe this is the wrong price, but honestly, the 100 mil says $403. I don't know. I definitely don't think this fragrance is worth $403 for 100 mil. Not taking shots. I'm just being honest here, guys. I mean, this should be more priced around the range of the Office for Men. If not, maybe Date. I don't really know what Date's going for these days. But again, I could have gotten that wrong. That might have been a bundle price. So you guys can correct me in the comments. But $403 for 100 ml of this, it's definitely not worth it. It smells nice, but I'm not being wowed right now. It's nothing special. Seems almost like he just... like Alberto Marias was just like, hey, let me just put this together. Now, if this is, you know, meant for blending, then maybe this will add, like, you know, this is supposed to accompany another fragrance and together they make something special. But honestly, I think if you added Date to this, it would probably just give it a stronger set of top notes, really. But again, that's a pretty expensive layering combo you're trying to accomplish there. It's almost got a little bit of like Bleu de Chanel, like that type of vetiver in it. And I'm not sure if Bleu de Chanel has patchouli in it, but I think it has a vetiver. So it's got a little bit of that earthy, rooty, citrusy, clean thing going that Bleu de Chanel brings to the table. Again, just a little bit, not a lot. So if you just picture a lot of citrus notes on top, but the orange oil is a little bit stronger. The orange oil is going to be a little bit stronger and give it a little bit more sweetness, like a lollipop. Mixed with the guaiac wood and that vetiver. It's going to be like a stronger version of Bleu de Chanel right now. That's what I'm getting right now. Again, that could change. It's only the first impression. But yeah, so not a bad fragrance so far. Right now, I can definitely tell you guys this is going to be worth the price. But you never know. It could change into something amazing. And maybe, again, if the price goes down, maybe I can recommend this one. I'm going to wear this one tonight and over the next few days. Give you guys an update shortly. Talk to you then.
All right, guys. Well, I'm back with my update for Black Tie from the House of Fragrance One. Yeah, so I spent the last couple of days with this fragrance. And I got to say, it's okay. It's not my favorite fragrance from the house. You know, like I mentioned, the first half of the video, I started off with that really nice, those citrusy notes. The mandarin, the lemon, and the orange oil. I got the orange oil a lot more than the other ones, honestly. Very strong, very sharp orange oil note in there. It smells like a very fresh orange. Like right when you peel that, when you peel the skin and you get the oils on your fingers and you smell it, you get that really deep, strong orange oil note. That's what you get mostly from this. Also did mention that I got like magic marker type of smell. I know you guys probably chuckled out there, but honestly, I went back to the website and looked. I was thinking, man, did I miss something here? Why am I getting magic marker, and why am I getting, you know, some other notes that aren't listed here? And in the description, he says that it's a smoky, leathery fragrance, which is weird because, I mean, from here, what I'm looking at, there's no smoke in this. There's no smoke in the notes, and there's no leather in the notes. But I think that magic marker thing I got was the smokiness. because it sort of reminds me a little bit of the smokiness from Cape Heartache, but this one's a lot, like I said, almost Magic Mercury type of, which is kind of weird, honestly. But that's the kind of note that I got from this. And I don't know where, again, leathery, I don't know where that is in the notes, but I sort of get like a leather type of animalic note with this. Again, I don't see it in the notes. I don't know where that came from. That's how he described it. So, you know, maybe it's in there, or maybe some of these notes combined to make that sort of fragrance. But that's what I get out of this. And that's pretty much all I really get. I get a lot of the citrus notes. I get that off-putting smoky note. I get some of the wood, so the guaiac wood. The cardamom is sort of there. It gets a little bit of sexiness, but it's toned down. I don't get a lot of your traditional patchouli. And I get some of the vetiver for some earthiness, but overall it's going to be the top notes, the smokiness, mainly the citrus notes and the smokiness and a little bit of that leatheriness, but mostly just a smoky citrus note or fragrance is what I get out of this. I can see why he said you could blend it with the two other ones, the Date for Men and the Office for Men, because I can see how it would go well for this, but honestly, not really sure if it's really worth the price. Longevity for this fragrance was excellent. I did get 8+ hours with this fragrance every time I wore it. And so, you know, it is an extrait de parfum. So it did last 8+ hours. Projection for this fragrance was really good as well. It is extrait de parfum, like I mentioned before. So you're getting good projection. Now, it's not beast, but I got wafts throughout the day. Like all day, even after the dry down, after the sixth, you know, hour, I was still getting decent wafts out of it. Not filling up a room, but I know this thing will definitely get noticed throughout the day. Seasons for this fragrance, well, you know, I think with some of these note combinations, it's going to be pretty open when it comes to the seasons. I think you guys are going to be able to make up your own mind on what seasons you want to wear this fragrance, because I think this fragrance is going to be good year-round. Honestly, the citrus notes on top give it a nice freshness, but that smokiness, you know, makes it okay or better and more appropriate for the colder weather, so like the fall and the winter and stuff like that, you know. But like this, I don't think it's too much to where you're gonna offend somebody in the summertime, but possibly, so maybe go easy on the trigger. But I do think you should be safe with this fragrance if you just go easy on the trigger and be able to wear this one year round. Occasions for this fragrance, well, this does have the nice citrus notes on top, which I thought initially, hey, maybe I can wear this one during the day, but that smokiness and that leatheriness that he mentioned on his website, you know, and just some of the darker notes like the patchouli and the vetiver and the cardamom gives it a little bit of that sexiness. This fragrance is definitely better for the evening events. It does say black tie. So, you know, formal events, black tie affairs, date night, just anything at night. This isn't a beast mode, but I definitely think it's strong enough for the club. Ages for this fragrance are going to be 25 and up. I do think this fragrance is pretty mature. Like maybe the opening, the first minute, it smells like it's going to be wearable for the younger guys. But once that smoke comes in and the other notes start to come together, it does get very mature and very black tie affair, which whenever I think of black tie affair, honestly, I think of older gentlemen. And also the price, guys, 100 mil of this stuff is $403. Again, I'm pretty sure there's going to be discounts, buy one, get ones, all that stuff that he runs. So it sounds like a lot. I think if you find a deal, you can probably save money. I know he's doing bundles, like selling a candle and maybe the travel spray and maybe a bottle, and it goes down quite a bit as well. But still, just on the surface, $403 is way too much for this fragrance. You're not really getting that much, honestly. And he's suggesting layering it with other fragrances. That's not going to work for me, guys. I'm not going to spend that much money on a fragrance that I'm going to layer. You know, it smells good on its own, but it's not that great on its own. So if you're telling me I'm spending that much money and I have to add other stuff to make it better, it's going to be a pass for me. Again, this 10 mil is $60 for 10 mil. That's a decant. $60 for 10 mil. I can't do that. I happen to get a great swap on this, so I didn't lose out too much on this fragrance. Again, good fragrance, but for that price, it's a little hefty, and it's a good fragrance, but it's not great. So overall, I do like this fragrance, but I'm not going to recommend that you guys go out there and blind buy this fragrance or even try it if you can't get a better price for this fragrance. Honestly, 100 mil should probably sell for about 165, honestly. I think that's what Office for Men's going right now. You should probably make this fragrance around that price. I mean, they're kind of similar with some of the notes, they have the citrus notes and stuff. This one just would make that one a little bit darker. But honestly, you know, there's not much to this fragrance. You get that citrus opening and it gets smoky and it gets a little dark and mature and it doesn't really go anywhere after that. Honestly, I think Date for Men might be his best composition. That one has a lot going on with it. It's very strong. It's very sweet. You get the freshness. You get the sexiness. You get the darkness. That's a great fragrance. Again, Black Tie, I don't know. It just seems like he put out something that resembles Office and Date, and he just took a lot out of it and just sort of gave you pieces of other fragrances in its own bottle and its own name. So to be honest, I wasn't a big fan of this fragrance. I think it's too expensive. I think he does. He makes good products. I think he hired an ace to do his fragrances. Alberto Marias is no slouch. The guy knows what he's doing. But this is more of a basic fragrance. Honestly, I wasn't wowed by this one. I might have mentioned in the first half. It's almost like a dark, smoky Bleu de Chanel type of fragrance, and sort of. Kind of like that. You know, a lot of citrus notes in this. So I can sort of maybe give it that resemblance. But honestly, there's nothing really special with this fragrance. And this isn't taking a shot at Jeremy or his hard work. He's accomplished more with his career when it comes to fragrances than I have. But, you know, I'm being honest, guys. That's what I'm here for. Be very transparent. Let you guys know what's on my mind and how I'm feeling. And so, yeah, Black Tie is going to be a pass for me. And I won't suggest you guys go out there and, you know, just blind buy this one. If you can get a good deal on it, maybe give it a chance. All right, guys, now it's your turn. Has anyone ever tried a Black Tie from the House of Fragrance 1? If you have, let me know your thoughts on this fragrance down in the comments below. All right, thank you guys so much for watching our video on my channel. If you like this video, please click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications for future first impressions videos and fragrance-related content just like this. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Dollars and Cents. There, you'll find fragrance-related photos and future contest winners. And as always, until next video, you guys take care. Thanks.